Thank you. So I'm going to talk about Lake St. Clair yellow perch growth, and I don't know how many people here have fished for yellow perch at Lake St. Clair. Awesome. So I'm glad we got some people that are very familiar with the Lake St. Clair yellow perch fishery. So this includes some collaborative work between us and Central Michigan University. I got co-authors listed from each and then co-authors from our station. So as many of you may know, Lake St. Clair yellow perch growth has declined over time. So I'm going to get into kind of when that started happening and kind of what we think caused that decline. There we go. So just a little bit of a general background on yellow perch. So yellow perch are, they're a very important species. So ecologically, they eat a lot of things on the lower food web. So they're aquatic insects, maybe some small fish. But then they're also prey for a lot of the important prey or predator species in Lake St. Clair. So you got your northern pike, your muskie, your smallmouth bass, walleye, all those feed on yellow perch. So it's kind of like this species that kind of helps move energy throughout the system. They're also very recreationally important. So a lot of you guys said you fish for yellow perch or fish for yellow perch in Lake St. Clair. So a lot of anglers are out there targeting yellow perch, but also they're a very good introductory species to like young anglers. I got my son there, he likes fishing. So they're very accessible to younger anglers. So it gets kids involved in fishing. Then economically, they're obviously got a lot of anglers coming to fish for yellow perch, brings money to local economies. In different areas, lakes or yellow perch are a commercial fish species that commercial fishermen fish for. Then restaurants are obviously a very, very important species economically. But in Lake St. Clair, I'm going to talk about in this presentation the good, the bad, and the ugly. So I don't know if you guys are familiar with the Clint Eastwood movie, but this is the yellow perch version of the good and the bad and the ugly. And I'm going to start with the good. So on Lake St. Clair, yellow perch, it's a very popular fishery. So especially in the ice fishery. So on the lower left, this is a picture out on Lake St. Clair on a day when people are almost all targeting yellow perch. So obviously a lot of people go out there and they love to fish for perch. They're the most harvested fish on Lake St. Clair. So you got walleye out there, you got a lot of fish species on Lake St. Clair. Yellow perch are the most harvested fish. They also have the highest targeted harvest rate. So people that are targeting yellow perch, they have a higher harvest rate than other species such as walleye. And then our survey catch rates at least show that their numbers are relatively stable. So on the lower left, I'm not sure if this pointer, yep. So you can see that there's some peaks over time, but overall it's relatively similar across the time period. So it doesn't seem like there's really a trend upward or downward of the total population based on our survey years. So now we get into the bad. So the bad, so harvest rate and total harvest have declined over time in Lake St. Clair. So anglers aren't able to catch as many or harvest as many fish per hour, and they're not taking as many fish home throughout the season. They also have lower harvest rates than nearby Great Lakes water. So they have lower harvest rates than what we see in Lake Erie. The size of harvest has declined. So compared to what anglers used to harvest, the fish they're keeping now are smaller than they used to be. The size of harvest of perch, similar to the catch rates, is also lower than nearby Great Lakes waters of Lake Erie. So fish people are taking home on Lake St. Clair, they're smaller than the fish people tend to take home on Lake Erie. So because of all these things, you can imagine there's fewer anglers that want to go out and target yellow perch. So we've seen a decline in anglers that specifically target yellow perch. And then there's less charter effort. So charter fishermen, they're spending less time targeting yellow perch. Maybe some of that has to do with some really good small bass fishing and walleye fishing. So there's other opportunities that they can pivot to. And then we're getting more angler complaints of fewer large fish in Lake St. Clair. And that kind of, the trend kind of bucked there this winter. There's a lot of people talking about big yellow perch through the ice fishery. And a lot of that probably has to do less with growth and more with survival. There's been some weak ice fishing opportunities up until this year. So there's probably increased survival of some of those larger perch up until recently. So now the ugly. So the ugly is kind of what we think happened or what our data shows. So in the Great Lakes, there's been a lot of food web changes. So a lot of that's due to invasive species. And specifically, I'm going to talk about the dry-sided mussels, or you're familiar with zebra and quagga mussels. So those have removed a lot of the nutrients from the system. Water clarity has increased throughout the system, and that led to a significant food web shift in Lake Huron. So on the right-hand side here, we got Lake Huron up here, St. Clair River flows into Lake St. Clair, then Detroit River. So in 2003-2005, there's a significant regime shift in Lake Huron, and Lake St. Clair gets 97% of its water from Lake Huron. So if there's a big change in the water in Lake Huron, so less nutrients, that's going to eventually reach Lake St. Clair. And From here on out, we're going to talk about some of the downstream effects we've seen in Lake St. Clair. So this figure here shows water clarity. So you can see I got secchi depth here. Secchi depth is, we use this gear called a secchi disc. It's a black and white disc. We lower it in the water, and once we can't see it anymore, that's our secchi depth. So pretty simple tool that we use out on the boat. So over time, you can see we found with analysis, we saw there was a break point or change point here after the year 2007, where the average water depth in Lake St. Clair or clarity in Lake St. Clair increased. So you can see it's about 1 meter higher water clarity after that 2007 change point. And then when we look at yellow perch growth, it had nearly the exact same change point. So we got this year class of yellow perch after 2007, growth or the lengthened age of age two perch dropped, end of age four perch dropped. So it's, I don't think that's a coincidence. So you get that water clarity increase, probably fewer nutrients in the water, less prey for yellow perch. You're getting that decline in growth. And this figure down here just shows the growth curves of yellow perch for those two time periods. So you can see the black line is the early time period. So kind of these, this period here before 2007, and this is the recent time period. As you see, there's a pretty decent difference early on. It kind of, the gap kind of closes as the fish get older. I think yellow perch are probably able to use more fish in their diets, and that allows their growth to kind of rebound a little bit. But looking closer at yellow perch diet, so this is where yellow perch kind of fits into the Lake St. Clair food web. I can see, as I mentioned, they're prey to a lot of these species up here. And then they eat a lot of these aquatic insects, amphipods, zooplankton, stuff like that. So we've got some diet studies that we've done on Lake St. Clair to see how this their diets have changed over time. So back in 1993, there was a diet study conducted on yellow perch. So obviously that's when growth was high. And it was before that water clarity increase on Lake St. Clair. And then in 2019, we worked with Central Michigan University, did another diet study. At that time period, growth was low, and it's after that water clarity increase on Lake St. Clair. So this is what we found. These are just kind of the general results of those two diet studies. So up above, we got 1993, and below this horizontal line is 2019. And then we got three different age groups here. So age one, age two, and age three. So at age one, we got mayfly larvae, and amphipods were the two primary foods that age one yellow perch were eating. And then in 2019, you can see amphipods kind of disappears. We still got mayflies and these chironomids or midge larvae that yellow perch are eating. Then at age two, kind of the same two species, amphipods were primarily what was consumed, but also mayfly larvae. And then 2019, pretty much just the mayfly larvae. And then similar to age three, a lot of amphipods in 1993, and then mayflies in 2019. So you might be thinking, well, what's the big deal? They're still getting some food at least. But when you look at the energy density of these prey items, you can see amphipods have a lot more energy per gram of prey consumed than mayflies do. So if a fish is able to have a lot of these mayflies in their, or amphipods in their diet, they don't have to consume as much food to get the energy they need to grow. You can see fish have the highest energy as compared to these other prey items. But for a smaller yellow perch, they're going to have a hard time eating a minnow or a shine or something like that. And then getting into this figure here, this is kind of a yellow perch fact sheet we have on our website. So if you go to our Lake St. Clair Fishery Research Station website, you can see this fact sheet here. But I'm just going to point out in the lower left-hand side, we got our percent mature. You can see male fish are maturing at very small sizes at around 4 inches. So if you catch in a 4-inch fish and it's a male, it's likely to be a mature fish. So that's just kind of depressing when you really think about it, because once they reach maturity, their growth tends to really slow down as well. So just another ugly thing to think about when you're looking at the good, the bad, and the ugly. So in conclusion, yellow perch growth has declined in Lake St. Clair. And as I pointed out, yellow perch diets have shifted. So fish are smaller and they've shifted from amphipods to mayflies, which is a decrease in the energy density of the food they're taking in. And then the food web has likely shifted in Lake St. Clair. So I mentioned the food web shift in Lake Huron, that's likely kind of transferred down into Lake St. Clair. A lot of that's caused by invasive species. So just something to keep in mind when you see that the decline in growth is that change in the ecosystem overall. So what can we do? Is there anything we can do to improve yellow perch growth? It's really something that's kind of difficult to do as far as a management perspective. Perhaps some nearshore habitat restoration. This nearshore habitat can benefit aquatic insects, stuff like that, gives them stuff to reproduce in and hang out in. Invasive species monitoring, control, and regulations, that's obvious important. We can see that dressing and mussels and other invasive species have been a detriment to the ecosystem. So just continuing to monitor for invasive species and control them when possible. And then supporting good water quality in Lake St. Clair and the Great Lakes overall. But with that, I'd like to thank you all for your attention.